Hi guys, so today I wanted to do a little bit of a different sort of video and show you guys my entire Nintendo Switch collection. I asked you guys to vote on Twitter and on YouTube if you wanted to see just my games or if you wanted to see all of my accessories and everything as well, and you guys said to show it all. So we're gonna go through everything that I've accumulated since we got our very first Switch a few years ago. So I do own the yellow Switch Lite, and I also own the Animal Crossing limited edition regular Switch, and we do have an original Switch as well that is in the living room, but these are the two that I use the most. The one in the living room usually Brandon or his brother use, so these are the ones that I use. This one I primarily take when we're going on road trips, so like if we're going to a concert or if I have a tattoo appointment or something. Otherwise I'm probably going to be using this one. I've been using this one around the house in handheld mode and in dock mode. All I have on this one are some little thumb grips, and they are the little paw prints, and they're super super cute. And then on this one I have some thumb grips as well. It is an Eevee and Pikachu thumb grip because I thought that they went with the yellow really well. And I do have a clear case on it with a bunch of stickers from Redbubble that I cut out. So we have Youngblood, we have a picture of Callum, it says sweet like honey, radiate positivity, and we have some of the 101 Dalmatians in a sunflower. So I actually customized the back of this, and I love doing stuff like this. I did this to my MacBook when I had it, and I used to do this to phone cases, so I really like that it's on here. I do want to give a quick shout out to a company that reached out to me and sent me some cases for free to review and share with you guys. And that company is Moco. They emailed me and reached out and just offered to send me some stuff to share with you guys and review, and I really appreciate it. Thank you so much for sending these over. And they sent me some cases here, so I wanted to show them to you first. So they sent me two for my big Switch. They sent me this one, which I think is so different. I've never seen a Switch case like this. It's almost like reminds me of like a clutch bag. It's very, very soft fabric, and it's got a little pocket here with an elastic on the inside to slide your games in. And it's just so slim that I don't think anyone would assume that there's a Switch in here. So here's the Switch on the inside. It does snap and everything. And it's very, very snug. I don't know necessarily if this would be really protective. I think this is more of like a fashionable case, but it is definitely an option and it is different. And like I said, you can go ahead and store the cartridges in it. I just think it's so cool because it's a case that I've literally never seen before. All links to the cases that they sent me will be in the description below if you guys are interested in picking them up for yourself. And the other case that they sent me for the full-size Switch looks like a Mario. It's so cute. It's got like the little overalls, so you actually unsnap these, and I've seen cases like this before on Wish and stuff, so I thought it was really cute to get one. And it unzips, and it's pretty much like a standard Switch case that you would normally get, and it just kind of sits snug like that. You could put your games in there. It's got two rows for games, and then it's got the little thing up here where you could put your accessories or more game cartridges. This one fits really snug, a lot better than the other one in my opinion, and again I do think that it is really, really cute. It's so different. I almost wish that this was like a pocket, like an overall pocket, so you could stick stuff in it or in the front even. And in case you guys were wondering, the current case that I am using for my Switch is the Animal Crossing leaf case. Next up, for the Switch Lite, we do have a little silicone rubber case. I do own some very similar to this already, which I'll show you guys in a second, and I own them in some different colors, so it was really nice to get a yellow one for a change. I love the feel on these cases. They're literally so soft to the touch, and they're just really comfortable. They don't feel like slippery or anything. And then lastly, they sent me this, and I am so excited about this. This is like a really hard impact case for the Switch Lite, and it's super, super thick, and it's probably honestly my favorite thing that I got. So you set your Switch Lite in here, and then it's got not one, but two slots for games. So you have this one here, and then you also have this one as well. So there's two different slots inside there. So you guys can kind of see it's Velcroed behind. and then it's got another row for games, and then it's got a zipper pocket up at the top, so you can put your, you know, your Joy-Cons or any extra controllers that you think you might want to use with your Switch Lite, and all that stuff, your extra thumb grips, everything. I love this and think that I'm going to make this my new case to store my Switch Lite just because of how durable it is, and I really, really like this case. So I would highly, highly recommend this one if you guys have a Switch Lite. And if you guys are wondering, the current case that I am using for my Switch Lite is my customized Dalmatian case. My mom ironed on these Dalmatians for me, and I have a little Charmander keychain on it. And on the inside, we have some games here. I have 5 games in here, and then we have my extra thumb grips. Okay, so let's get into the accessories real quickly. So this is our controller bin here. We have the Zelda wireless controller. This one takes AA batteries. It is not rechargeable, which is kind of a bummer, but it does look really cool. We also have the Zelda D-pad extra little Joy-Con, so it makes it a little easier to play Breath of the Wild and stuff. I got this for Brandon for Christmas. It was on sale for like $4 or $5 at Target, and I thought that it looked so cool, and I believe he's used it. So we have a standard black wireless pro controller. These are the rechargeable ones. And then we have 2 of the Super Smash Bros. Wireless controllers. We have the highlighter yellow ones. I picked these out because I love highlighter yellow. We have the Splatoon pair, so it's the green and the pink. And then we have the bright red original Joy-Con. The blue one broke, so we just have this one. And then we have another set of the red and blue, so we have a duplicate set that's actually on our Switch now. Some glass screen protectors, sticker Zelda decals as well for the original Switch. And then when it comes to cases, we have this case for the original Switch, which was one of the more durable cases that I was talking about earlier. And this is what we use for our big Switch when we take it places. Then I have several cases for my Switch Lite. I have this kind of foggy clear silicone case, and it's got like the extra little like grippers on the bottom, so it makes it a little more comfortable to hold if you're going to be playing it for a long time. And then here's a yellow version of that, very similar. And then you can actually store 2 games in the back as well if you wanted to. This yellow case that has the thumb grips as well. They're really small though, and I don't think that they fit the Switch that well because it's like this whole bar, so it makes it a little uncomfortable versus just like the original bump at the bottom. And you can actually store 4 game cartridges right at the top, so they're really convenient to pull out and change your game. Then I have this silicone case, and it is yellow, and it also came with a screen protector as well. So this is what it looks like. I've never used this, obviously. It has a little bit of texture here. And yeah, I got this from my friend. She actually found this at the bin place, which I've made several videos on before, and it's where you can get some like return items. So she found this on 50 Cent Day and gave it to me, which is really nice because she knew I have a yellow Switch. And then similar to that yellow silicone one from Moco, I have this gray silicone Switch case that I got from the bin place. And I have used this one before and I really did like it before I got my clear hard shell case. And so now I have this one. And then I have some thumb grips here. I again got these at the bin place for 50 cents. And there's various different sizes and everything to add to the Joy-Cons. Now we do have 2 of the Steelbook cases. So we have this one, which is from the Pikachu and Eevee games. So it's got Pikachu on the front and Eevee on the back. And then they're kind of silhouettes on the inside. And then we also have the Super Smash Bros. One that came with the Pro Controller. So these aren't going to really be in any particular order, but first off, we do have Animal Crossing. Obviously, I've talked about this a lot on my channel. It's my current game. I don't really need to say any more about it, but Animal Crossing is obviously a must-have if you guys are getting a Switch or thinking about getting one. Next up, we have two games that I've never opened before, but it is Owlboy and Scribblenauts Showdown. These were part of Target's like 50% off video game sale, so this game only ended up being $10. $10, and this one is one that I've wanted since we first got a Switch. I finally got it because they had it and it was 50% off, so it was only $15, which is the cheapest I've ever found this game. I just haven't gotten around to playing it, but now that we're in isolation for another 30 days, might as well go ahead and crack this bad boy open and give it a play. So I think I'm going to give this one a try pretty soon here. I'm super excited. And the Scribblenauts I think would be a fun game to play with Brandon. Next up we do have Resident Evil. So I have the Resident Evil Origins collection as well as the Resident Evil Revelations collection. I finally bought this one. I wanted this one for a while. I thought about getting it on Black Friday at Walmart, but I didn't and I regret that to this day. But I finally got it at our exchange store. So I just used some store credit that we have. So I ended up getting it for free. I haven't started playing it yet. I know Brandon's brother played like a few seconds of it, I assume, but it is in here, so this is another game that I want to go ahead and start soon, and now is the time. And Resident Evil Revelations, so this has the first and the second game. I've actually played both of these and beat them. I played Resident Evil Revelations on my 3DS, and I played Resident Evil Revelations 2 on my PlayStation, and I think I own Resident Evil Revelations on my Xbox 360 if I'm not mistaken. So definitely really like the Revelations. I get that they're not everyone's cup of tea and not everyone enjoys them, but they are honestly one of my favorite Resident Evil games. Next up we have one of my favorite games of all time on the Switch. It is Ni No Kuni: Wrath of the White Witch. This game is fantastic. The fact that the animations are animated by Studio Ghibli gives me so much joy since I watched so many of those movies when I was little, from Castle in the Sky to Kiki's Delivery Service. It's incredible. And I'm not a huge RPG person, but this is a whole nother level. The animations that they put into this, the art style, the characters, the storyline, the plot, it is so, so heavy. I think I've got probably 15 to 20 hours in this game, and I don't even think I'm a quarter of the way done. It's a really time-consuming game, and the animations, again, the cutscenes are so beautiful, and it's a really immersive experience. We have another cheap game. This is Penny Punching Princess. I got this at GameStop. I think it was like $5. It was dirt cheap because they were having like a pre-owned sale, and it's not my thing. Next up we have The Walking Dead: The Final Season. I have a complex relationship with this series. I got the first Walking Dead on my Xbox 360. I got the second season on my PlayStation 3, and I got Michonne and season 3 on my PlayStation 4, and here I am with the final season on my Switch. So you see my dilemma here. I really wish that I was able to play all of the series on one device, because that way your stories can connect with each other, and I never got to have that experience when I played the game, so I feel like I was really missing part of it, you know, when I played. But I did enjoy all of the seasons that I did complete. I have not played this one yet, and I think I only got halfway done with season 3, but these are really easy, you know, just decision-based games. I love the comic style. I think that's what the series is known for. Alright, I think it's time to show you guys all of our Mario games. So we have Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, Luigi's Mansion 3, Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games, and Super Mario Odyssey. Now, Super Mario Odyssey and Mario Kart were obviously some of the first games that we got for our Switch. This is exactly like the one that was on the Wii U. Super Mario Odyssey was absolutely phenomenal. This is the first game that I completed on the Switch and played all the way through. This one I was super excited for because I've played the other Mario and Sonic games, but this one, the controls, honey, and the time limits just ain't it. We have our Zelda games. So we have Zelda Link's Awakening, we have Zelda Breath of the Wild, and we have Hyrule Warriors. Definitely not my demographic. This is more Brandon and his brother, so they've played these games and they've enjoyed them. Definitely Breath of the Wild, I can tell you right now, is probably the more most played game ever in the history of our Switch lifestyle. We have Fire Emblem Warriors. I really wanted this game, and I had a lot of fun playing it with Brandon. I thought it was just a really nice hack and slash. I like the combat style in it. Harvest Moon Light of Hope is one of my favorite games on the Switch as well. I know this received a lot of criticism, and a lot of people did not like this game at all. I have been a hardcore Harvest Moon fan ever since I got my 3DS. I was playing all the Harvest Moons that I could possibly get on there and playing them for hours on end. So when this came out, this is all I would play when I would go to Brandon's apartment and we would play the Switch. This was it. This was it right here. Nintendo staples here. We have Kirby Star Allies, Yoshi's Crafted World, and Captain Toad. Our Pokemon games. So the newest one is Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Rescue Team DX. Holy crap, was that a mouthful. And then we have Pokemon Sword and Shield, and then Pokemon Let's Go Eevee and Pikachu. The reason why we have both variants is because Brandon would play one, I would play the other. However, I never played either of these, and I couldn't even tell you which one Brandon played. I was not paying attention. These, I did have a lot of fun when I did play the game, and I thought it was a good Pokemon experience. I loved being able to throw the Pokeball and the way that it kind of implemented Pokemon Go with it. All right, we have some fun little quirky games here. We have Overcooked 2, Sushi Striker, The Way of the Sushido. That one's a tongue twister. This one is Layton's Mystery Journey, Catrelli and the Millionaire's Conspiracy Deluxe Edition. That's just a mouthful. And then we have Little Dragon Cafe. I've never played Little Dragon Cafe, but it looked so similar to Harvest Moon, and it's from like the original Harvest Moon game. It's like from the same creator. My list is ever growing with my Switch collection. This one I've actually played a pretty decent amount. I love the puzzles, I love the art style, and I just think it's really adorable. It's a very like brain teaser sort of game. And then Sushi Striker, I got this for I think $10 at GameStop, and I was so excited because when it was announced I wanted it, but I couldn't comprehend spending the full price on it. And it's really, really fun. It's really adorable, it's very simple, and I just love the style of it, like the fact of like trying to match all the colored plates and stuff and throwing them at your opponent. It's just super funny, and the cutscenes are amazing in this as well. Holy crap, the animation and everything that they did for the cutscenes is crazy. Like, you wouldn't expect it for the type of game that it is. Next up here we have Minecraft. Not my cup of tea, not my realm, but Brandon and his brother bought this and they've played it. Next up we have Monster Hunter Generations Ultimate. I picked this up because there was another Monster Hunter game that Brandon wanted for the Xbox, and this was part of the Target 50% off sale, so this only ended up being $10. And the little cat on the back, the Siamese cat, is adorable. I do not care. Alright, we're down to our last few games and I'm running out of breath. We have Splatoon 2. I've wanted this for a while. I finally got it on Black Friday, and I did have a decent amount of fun with it. I didn't really play it that long, and I want to get into it, so this is another game that I think I'll play now that I have the Switch in the bedroom where I can play it on the TV. I still haven't gotten to it. Spyro, the trilogy, Brandon bought this for me. I played this on our way to see Five Sauce, I think, and I had a lot of fun with it. I never ended up going back to it for some reason, but I did put a decent amount of time into it. This is another one of the Target 50% off games. This is Yonder, the Cloud Catcher Chronicles. This game just looked super cute. It kind of made me feel like it was almost like a Zelda Breath of the Wild sort of thing, like an open world, and there's some enemies, but there's also these really cute animals that you can like befriend, and they look so adorable, and the art style looks really different, so I really wanted to give this a try. I think I ended up paying $15 for this as well. Some really just fun, simple Disney games. I got Cars 3. This was another Target 50% off game. I think this was only $10 or $5. Kind of got it as a joke since Brandon would always whoop my butt in Mario Kart, and guess what? I beat him. So we never played it again because he got really mad that I was beating him. Aladdin and the Lion King, the classic games. This is really cute, really fun. Next up we have New Super Lucky's Tale. This is something that I got from GameStop for like their pre-owned, whoa, I caught it, their pre-owned games, and I remember when this came out, it hasn't been that long, I was really invested in wanting to play this game. And for some reason it reminded me like of Conker's Bad Fur Day. I mean, I know it's nowhere near that, this is rated E, but just the characters kind of made me think of that for some reason. I definitely want to give this a try. I think this would probably be at the top of my list to play and try out since I'll be home. And then the last game we have here is Wonder Boy, The Dragon's Trap. This was one of the first games I ever wanted for the Switch, and my mom got it for me for Christmas. I wanted this in Owlboy for the longest time, and I played this for a pretty decent amount. It's so cool to switch between the retro mode and the modern mode that they like reanimated. It's just really cute and different, and I got a lot of joy out of it. I want to go back to this one as well and finish it. I have a habit with the Switch games, especially, of starting them and not finishing them, versus on my PlayStation, like, if I start a game, I'm going to finish it. Like, I have to finish it. So that is my entire Switch collection, from the consoles to the accessories to the games, and it's really overwhelming, obviously, especially since I haven't even played half of the games that we own. Granted, some of them are Brandon's and he's played them, so I guess it's a little bit different. But let me know in the comments down below which of these games you think I should get to first, or which of these games you think I should do a play with me, like a walkthrough sort of thing. Maybe like I'll try it for the first time, like Super Lucky's Tale, or maybe one of the Pokemon games or something. Like, let me know, because that's definitely something I could film while I'm in isolation. Help me out, please. I don't want to lose my mind. That's all I got for you today. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for Moco again for sponsoring this a little bit and sending me those products to go ahead and review and share on my channel. I really appreciate it. I love you guys, and I'll see you again very, very soon. Peace out, Girl Scouts.